In every evil age that we read about in God's Word, there has always been a challenge to that evil age. And there has always been, thank God, the triumph and the victory of God's people in an evil age. When they were burning the saints of God, thank God the gospel burned with mighty fire. And we are confronted today in our day with darkness. Darkness in the pulpits, darkness in the colleges, darkness in the university, darkness in the assembly, darkness in the convention, darkness in the council of churches, ecclesiastical, religious, spiritual darkness. So God doesn't leave the darkness unchallenged. What God did in creation, He is still doing today. And the enemy shall come in like a flood. The Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard. What? Against them. Yes, we're against them. I'm against the Pope. You remember that. I'm against the World Council of Churches. I'm against the National Council of Churches. I'm against the great apostate denomination, whether it be Episcopalian, Presbyterian, Baptist, or called by any other name. You let them know you haven't come as a soft voice sissy to be another pulpit ornament 2 times on Sunday. That you're not a soft peddling, fence-straddling, cream puff pie preacher, that you're a man of God with fire in your belly. It's fundamentalism versus apostasy. Pseudo-fundamentalists, they come into the fundamentalist nest, they would use the fundamentalist money, and they would destroy the fundamentalist stand. A fundamentalist is a person who has no other foundation but Jesus Christ. He's built upon the rock of Egypt. Thank God no potency will disintegrate that rock. It'll stand forevermore. And a woman came to me some time ago, and she said to me, I don't like your church. You're always battling. There's always a scrap, a fight on. You're always fighting. She says, in our church, we have perfect peace. I said, madam, I've been in many a graveyard. There's plenty of peace there. The peace of the dead. You can have that. I may not be able to deal with you, Lucifer. I may not be able to silence you, Beelzebub, but God Almighty will silence you. It's easy, you know, to be on fire for God and praise the Lord when revival's on and people are getting saved. But old Habakkuk said, when there's no oxen in the stall, when there's no food in the larder, when there's no harvest in the field, I will rejoice in the God of my salvation. And until you learn that, you'll never be a true man or woman of God.